Well, I'm going to be a great fan
first
of
game.
someone else's stream.
Alright then, that is awesome. And
You know,
I must
you
say,
just quickly,
welcome.
Doing that. And I'm ready to go, boys.
You're finally
D-man,
ready.
D-man, is it quite bad that I don't even follow you?
Stein, thanks for the follow.
Oh, don't worry about it, I don't follow him.
Same with me, man. I haven't followed D-man yet.
Don't
what,
worry,
D-man?
Stein just followed, so thanks for
oh,
that.
Oh, he's got
man.
A fedora.
Yes,
what's
yes
D-man?
I do.
Wait,
I
forgot what
D-man.
Your Twitch name is. It's D_man7000.
Yes. Now,
can't
anyways,
like the discard or something?
Let's try and actually get into this all.
By the way, your profile picture is kawaii.
Kawaii?
Kawaii.
What?
Your profile picture on Twitch.
Oh.
Oh, that old picture, yeah.
Kawaii. That's plenty old. That is, like, years. No, just like a couple, I think, though. But yes, let us at least try and venture with some D&D on the Master's Vault.
That's the one.
First time, huh?
Yep, this is the first time for basically everyone here.
Ooh, spooky.
Be gentle, senpai.
Please.
Oh my.
Let
me see what I can't try and.
Oh shit, we meant to have a notepad. Like,
wait,
does that help?
I don't know.
That'll do, right?
Let me try and figure this out.
You guys have two screens.
That two screen life, right?
Yeah, shut up.
Right.
So, basically, let's try and at least get to know each other better. Like, who are you? What? Who
oh,
are
right,
your
so
characters?
We start with a deep questions here, then.
Who are your characters? Let's try and go around the table.
I haven't
table.
Found myself yet, personally.
Who are your characters?
That's the one.
Right.
Let's go around the circle.
So, starting off with Oriana, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Alright. I'm not going to do a voice, just I'm not.
Thank God.
my name is Oriana. I'm a normal sized tiefling, neck length hair, and obviously the horns coming around and down. Grey eyes. Yeah. That's what we're going with. And I'm a bard from a small fishing village called Dewport. And I moved to Parabor to get better at being a bard.
Oh. Okay.
You're only grade 4 guitar, that was it.
Oh, Chubbs, thanks for following.
No problem.
Right. Chubbs, you're next.
Alright. My name is Doomin Dank Durison. I'm your typical dwarf. I like drinking, beating up things with a big battle axe. Not very good at fighting, but I'm just there to kind of keep the moral support up of the team.
That is the best part. You're terrible at fighting. I love it.
You're our main DPS. Love it.
No, no, it's fine. And then, what else should I say? Basically, my armor's a bit too big for me, so I only wear a chest plate, because I'm only like 4'3". So all I need is a chest plate, and it covers my entire body.
I love that.
And then I was on a bit of a budget, and I couldn't afford shoes. So I kind of wear like sort of sandals. That's all I could find. And that's about it.
You're a dwarf who wears sandals.
Yeah.
Socks.
I was on a but no, we don't have socks. I was on a budget, okay? I spent all my money on a sick chest plate.
On this sick chest plate.
Oh, God. Work. Now, let me at least ask you this much. Why do you have the nickname Dank?
Do I have to say? Do I really have to say? Like, it's me.
No, like,
that should be a good enough information.
In-game, no one knows what this word Dank means. Please
yeah,
tell
what,
us.
Why?
I'm like, it got
Demon,
from his
what
answer.
Does Dank mean?
I usually dank refers more along the lines of
like wet and kind of.
Yeah, like the sewer is dank, that kind of stuff.
They mean damp. Mm.
No, I mean dank.
Yeah, that's usually one.
Chubbs, yeah, didn't you get your nickname by fighting the mystical creature Harambe?
Oh no, we're breaking that.
You said it. How dare you call it a creature?
Are you seriously? It was
basically a demigod. How dare you call it a creature? I couldn't reach it. I'm too small.
Oh god.
Should carry a step into battle.
Oh god. Let's move on. Who's the next person now?
I guess.
Oh great.
Yep, it'd be you.
The lizardman man. So I'm Arogenia Bijold. I'm a giant lizard, of course. Why not? 6'3". I have no hair, unfortunately. Green eyes. And I've been banished from my village, man. So I'm a lone wolf.
You've been banished from your village?
Yeah, man.
Why were you banished?
Because you set the place on fire? Yeah, an accident, man.
Oh,
look, my character has a bad temper, man.
I don't see an issue here.
Oh, no.
Every time anyone makes fun of me or my name, I get angry, man. So I set the place on fire on accident. So they banished me, and then I slay the dragon.
To redeem myself.
Accident. Don't worry, I didn't mean to burn down my entire home.
Don't worry, man. It's all fine. So yeah, that's me, man. Just a cool little lizard. Even though he's 6'3".
Right, that'd come around to me next, wouldn't it?
I was thinking maybe Grav next.
Grav would be wonderful, because I'm just trying to get rid of the alert sounds on that, because of course it's a little bit distracting when my man comes up, like, in the middle of a conversation.
Chaplain!
The mythical gods are speaking to us.
No, we lost Chaplain.
Yep, again.
Oh, boys. Okay. What is this? Entertainment break. Say something, Grav.
No, just Grav, keep going. Keep going.
First of all, by the way, I'm going to mute myself a lot because I'm coughing all over the place.
Why are you coughing? And
on to...
with a cold.
On to Mogravi. Who I am, very skinny. I don't know how to say this in a non-offensive way. I'm dark-skinned.
Black. You're tan.
Yeah, I'm a tanned wizard with long black braided hair. I have a little scar in the back of my neck that reminds me of the dangers that lizard people bring with them.
Lizard people.
No problem, man.
I love that.
I normally wear a long black hooded robe, and I carry a big staff around that does little tricks for me.
Just by itself.
What kind of tricks, man?
You sure that thing's a staff, right?
Tricks in bed or on the field?
Can I do a roly-poly?
And Chaplin's
it can't do a roly-poly, it can't do tricks.
Chaplin's saying this is why he doesn't use Skype.
I don't know what's happened with him.
It's possible that Skype crashed for him, I don't know.
Why?
But once he gets in, it'll just reset to what the cameras are like, so that's fine.
Pretty much. Thankful.
First time struggles, ain't it, really?
Yeah.
I like how on Bacon's fit, it's just your forehead.
It's just your forehead.
It's just my mouth.
I was just about to say that.
I like how Chewie's in Chaplin's spot at the moment. Just his teeth, though. Yeah. E-Man's okay. Grab, I've got your forehead. That's fine. I'm perfectly fine because I ain't moved.
As opposed to on my screen, where Chewie took up the entirety of Chaplin's. Actually, no, wait. Chewie took up Chaplin's area.
That's what you want. You want a massive Kappa Pride.
But anyways,
the Kappa Pride is untouched. Right, it's my turn, ain't it?
Yes, please.
Right. Basically, my name's Kelry. I I'm a little bit touchy on my past before coming to see the Master. So I'm currently, well, I came to see the Master at the age of 18. I had nothing to my name, that sort of thing.
Well, first off, let me say this.
Traveling.
First off, before you continue, I'd like to say this. We will explain a bit more of how you get to meet the Master in a bit. Yeah. So, at least leave that part of it alone for
now. Yeah, no, I'm just saying, my story about how I came to meet the Master and all of that and what happened before will come out probably later on in the tale. So I'm going to try and
about as
serious.
Soon as you're done.
At least you're on the same level. I love it. Master.
Or at least Chapman's back, or at least his cousin.
Yeah, I gave up on my laptop.
Oh. Can't see your webcam anymore.
Yes, because I don't have one.
Okay, get
it.
Given up on my laptop. It's decided it doesn't like the internet today.
Wait,
yeah,
so,
picture like me, just not a cup of pride.
So you don't have a picture?
I'll restart my laptop and see if that does it.
Okay, hopefully.
If you don't mind, yeah. But yeah, pretty much, just going to quickly go on and describe me. I near enough dress in nondescript clothes because, of course, being a bit of a burglar, a bit of a thief, a rogue, whatever, I try not blend in. I'm just being a bit inconspicuous, like, you know, so I don't stand out that much. Brown eyes, blonde hair. Yeah, we'll go with that for now. Right, D-Man, do you want to start us off on a quest?
Yes, as a matter of fact, let's get a bit to this. Very much heads up, I have my laptop right here. It's got the PDF, so whenever I look over here, I got both chats in the PDF, so yeah.
That's good.
That's so what we then, like.
That is what I did. This one is acceptable. Now, this here, first off, we are going to start back in time, since this is our first time play D&D, especially 5th edition. So, by starting off, we'll be 6 months back, and Ilaria Feywing, known throughout all the kingdom of Skylark as the Master.
Right, so the Master of
you...
Skyrim.
Skylark.
Go on, sorry. Skylark.
Let the man tell his story, come on. Right.
She took you all in as her pupils somehow, and she is an old elf woman, and yet you kind of know how it is with fantasy and elves. They age like, I don't know, fine wine or something like that.
Yeah, they last a long time, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And she would look absolutely beautiful to today, even if she's, what, 300, 500 years old. She looks like she's in her 20s, probably. She is very skilled in magic as well as physical combat and survival. As a matter of fact, she is absolutely legendary with it all. That is why she is known as the Master. She had trained Marigold the Brave, who had slew the infamous Great Blue Dragon.
What?
Diraxthi.
My species, you might.
Diraxthi? I don't know how to say this. I'll probably.
The first one was right.
Species.
I don't know how to say it. Diraxthese. And
following the boss in the
Diraxthese.
Just make up something.
Okay,
and
sure.
Just roll with it. Roll with it.
I beat him on
Bloten Buttertree, who closed the demon portal of Nargoth, and so many other famous heroes, probably even Hercules at this rate. And all of them. Wait, and of all the would-be treasure seekers, mercenaries, do-gooders that came across her doorstep begging for her wisdom. It was you all, only you, that were the few selected by Ilaria herself. Now then, why did you come to the Master's Mansion before beginning your life of adventure?
Where you go?
Yeah, mine's 3 years, I did. 2 years, sorry.
So I accidentally put it down my couch already, man.
Okay. Alright, continue on, D-Man.
No, that is it. That is what I asked you. Right. I asked you all, why is it that you all came to the Master's Mansion before beginning your lives of adventure?
Because everyone else didn't want to be left out.
Okay, that is fucking brilliant.
Right, my reason for coming to the Master was pretty much, I'm sort of like traveling around. I've got previous like knowledge as being a bit of a thief, that sort of thing. Just hanging about in Parable and then hearing the tale just in a back alley of this Master, and you know, she piqued my interest. I had to go meet her, and so from making connections with people, I finally got in touch with her, and I just want to learn, become the world's best thief. Near enough.
The world's best thief is quite an idea. However, I'll just say this. I'm not sure if she's okay with you stealing.
Come on, man.
This is why we need to know things.
She is a hero. She's trained heroes. Not really too many thieves, I would think. But
it's gonna be a fair...
who knows? Maybe there's some sort of other reason. Oh, jeez. What was this?
Steal from orcs?
What was this pop that's okay. That I heard?
The first one for everything, don't worry.
So, what do those things people...
Oh, wait, that was you, Chubbs?
What?
Oh, forget it. I thought I heard a bloop on Skype or whatever.
No, D-Man, it was in the Roll 20.
Oh.
Who's blooping?
I
suppose.
Okay, why is Chewie in the top one?
Chewie's trying to write.
Yeah. Actually, I forgot about that.
D-Man,
he's hitting himself down, man.
I forgot about that.
How do I move a character?
Please,
man?
Let's wait until after everyone else, Grav. I beg of you. This is okay, absolute please. Genius, though.
Okay, I'm lost.
Right, go.
What's going on, man?
No, just tell why you came to the Master.
Oh, Christ.
Oh, because I was banished, man. No, really.
But how do you hear about the Master? What makes you want to come to her and like learn about, you know, being a warrior, being a hero, that sort of thing?
I think because of the greybeards in the mountains, man. They told me. The greybeards told me, man.
The greybeards in the mountain. So grab.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Just that people with beards, okay?
Make your own damn story, dude.
Don't just steal every fucking thing from Skyrim.
The plagiarism alarm bells are ringing.
Man, I haven't seen anything, man. It's my idea to read my own finish, man. That was my idea.
Does this mean I need to learn that the Dragonborn comes?
Right, Chapman, your turn. Where have you come to the Master?
Well, as I said before, I was traveling between my small fishing village to the main city, and during that time I was ambushed by bandits. Unfortunately, Ilaria was there to save my life, so obviously that sort of changed my perspective on the world a little bit, and I wanted to give something back. As well as being a bard and telling stories, I wanted to have my hand in creating them and helping people out. So Ilaria was obviously the right person for me to learn that.
Very noble.
Very nice.
And then Grav.
Actually, no, Chubby.
I already said mine.
Chewie or Chubby?
Scrubs was first.
I'm last, Bacon.
Sorry,
I didn't hear hers then.
Oh, you did, you laughed. Because everyone else did, and I kind of didn't want to be left out.
No, I was laughing at this thing. I guess you were speaking.
Oh, well, that just makes you feel worse about it now.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, man. I'm still.
Wait, demon.
What was it?
Yeah, so you know, all the cool kids in the realm went to that, you know, that this master. So I thought, all right, might as well go check it out. Don't want to be left out of the group. No real reason. Just wanted to have a look.
Okay. For some reason, she accepted you out of everyone else.
Dwarf with ginger hair, what'd you expect?
Oh, yeah, sure, okay.
Can't deny one of those at your doorstep.
Oh my god, I can't believe I forgot about this one. I will admit, I had this plan for a while when Grav was making his character. I'm like, I thought this would be amazing. Please, take it away, good sir.
Alright, yeah. So I was looking for shelter for a while because my
now,
old home...
Why were you looking for shelter?
Well, my old home, the Stawminder Wizard Tower, got destroyed. A storm like no one had ever seen came over the tower and destroyed it. And some rumors even say that some evil wizard did that on purpose to destroy the wizard tower. And after the death of all my fellow wizard companions, I had to find a place to sleep because the tower was no longer there. And Ilaria took me in. So, yeah, I stayed there for a while, and after a while, a fair bit of chemistry developed between me and Ilaria.
Oh.
So, as time passed, some stuff happened, you know? And, yeah, we became very, very good friends, if you know what I mean.
Give me more gravy. Is that why you have that name?
Oh god! Oh shit! I fucking love it. Now,
yeah, after a few years, I moved out of Ilaria's house because you know it was time to move on. But I still stayed close. And we have kind of a friends with benefits kind of relationship.
Oh,
and what other than that, she's still training you in multiple aspects.
Well, that's
the D-man went ahead and said that, oh, she's so pretty and all this shenanigans, and she's taken. I mean, what's this?
I'm like, I had this planned for something. I can't remember why I had it so planned.
So, I still don't know how to get my character off the board, man.
But, let's see here. Do-do-do. Afterwards. Okay.
I feel like in this story, there'll be a lot of favoritism going towards Graf because of his friends with benefits relationship.
Nah. What, with D-Man or with Delirio?
Unless you mess her over a bit, then.
Yeah, Chubbs, I'm friends with benefits with D-Man.
He's better, man. He's still getting better and better.
I don't think that's the friend.
Oh my! More gravy. Oh, Christ.
Oh, wow, guys.
It's got really carry on. It's getting weird. So.
Yeah.
Okay, next. I'm trying to think. Okay, so.
I love all this progress we're making.
Over the last half year previous to this, and. Quite possibly further.
So the day Gooms was born.
You've learned that Ilaria is quite an intense, but fair and encouraging teacher. Though the master is over 8 centuries old.
Right.
Her elf blood keeps her thin, lithe, and youthful, which allows her to enforce your rigorous training. So yeah, it's basically... Oh, your rigorous training regimen. Yeah. You're all learning different things from her. Like, some of you are learning magics, others are learning sword techniques. The dwarf is learning how to wield his axe better. Actually hit a target.
Actually how to pick it up, to be honest.
No, he could pick it up, he just couldn't actually hit the side of a fucking barn.
I could, just not all the time.
Oh, correct.
Just not all the time. Oh, no. I missed.
Yeah, so you're each learning different skills in magic, combat, and more. But you all take your meals together. And
oh,
one point.
Crap.
What?
Crap.
What? God fucking damn it, Crap! Oh, God!
Of course it would be Grav.
Okay, first off, Chaplin, how is your camera? Still.
I'm restarting my laptop.
Still restarting, still, okay.
That's a long restart, I'm just gonna say.
Okay, at this point.
It's next Tuesday, man.
Okay.
Windows XP right there.
He's still afraid to show his face.
Oh,
man.
Jesus. XP.
Get the dragon on cam, apparently.
Wingardium Leviosa.
Right.
Oh, next. God. But let's see here. You're all sitting at a long dining table, like old fashioned, nice wooden, maybe a bit polished. I don't know. Probably oak at this point. And you're all enjoying a nice warm breakfast together. Ilaria puts down her porridge spoon and stands up, looking at you all in the eyes. Her golden hair swaying. Framing her own green orbs. No, not those orbs. Too low, too low.
Too many innuendos. Good.
Let's see here. She cracks a smile as she begins speaking. It is time for your final test in real combat. We have a rat infestation in the basement. A giant rat infestation. I managed to get them contained in the larder, but they'll soon eat through all our supplies and door itself if you don't go down there to exterminate them. Her green eyes twinkle with mischievous delight as she adds, I also seem to have misplaced the key to the larder after locking them in, so you'll have to get through the door and past the barricade I set up before you can get to the rats. The master sits back down in her chair and puts a spoonful of porridge in her mouth, sipping it, looking seductively at Margrevy. Before actually eating, she looks at all of you and says, well, what are you all waiting for? Get going. You know by now that it's your cue to head down to the basement. Now, if you have any questions, you can ask away, and I will try my best to answer them.
All right.
How many there are?
Yeah, how many rats are there? Like, did you get a peek at how many rats?
How big are they? Is that what you know, man?
I don't know how many. They were just so ugly and disgusting, pitiful creatures.
Chapman, what are you measuring, man?
I'm being ready, man.
He's just doing the swag fingers, that's it.
Oh, yeah. How big are these rats?
These rats, man.
They're giant rats! For fuck's sake!
Are they bigger than me?
Oriana! Of all people, you should know they're giant.
How giant, man? How giant is giant?
Araginia?
Yeah. Are they bigger than a dwarf? If they are, that's a problem.
Yeah, I just want to know, man.
No, not larger. I'd say about as large as a dwarf.
That's just a bit worrying, then.
Okay, so I think we should should go with German already, man.
Why am I being the bait in this?
Yeah, man.
Sounds good.
You're the bait, and I'm just going to spit my fire, okay? Sounds like a solid plan, man.
Right, so, Kelry, with a bit of toast in their mouth, is just there like, right, let's get started then. Like, in the toast, sort of like, whilst getting out of the chair, walking down, going towards the stairs down to the basement. Does anyone follow me?
I'll jump in.
Would it be amusing if we all say no?
Just let everyone sit down, knock on down.
Yeah, yeah.
Come back 10 minutes later, done.
I'll run it behind him.
I'm still finishing my toast, man.
I'll jump in axe first. Okay, I'll just swing around.
So nothing else, just everyone's heading towards the larder?
Might as well just get done. It's only a few rats, you know. It's no big deal.
I will stay at the camp, man.
I've been in bigger things.
We need someone to defend the camp. That's me.
So Tree's there, just going to eat breakfast while we all go and actually...
I mean, Nick, I am cooking breakfast, okay? I will cook you breakfast with my fire breath, okay?
I'll pull
you breakfast out of my beard.
Well, it is kind of...
Calorie.
It is locked, and she did misplace the key somehow, so... Or did she?
Alright. Regina, run. Run at the door.
So, you're all at... You're all in the larder now? Okay then, allow me to just and move you all over into the larder.
Whoa! Things are happening.
Okay, things are happening now. Here we go.
So I think I should stay behind, man. I don't want to die there. Yeah.
I'll go in first. Cause
right. So
now someone drags. Someone drags you all along, and you're all down in the larder. Now, I just wanna... Mm-hmm. Let's see here. What does this say? When they head down... Okay, so the basement steps of Alaria's mansion lead down a stone passageway and into this small corridor fit for... I guess, two at a time. Side by side, at least. And it ends up at a wooden door. And at this point, you notice, you know, it's already locked, and they're all inside. You know that beyond the door is the larder, and it's filled with all kinds of manners of things. Cheese, meat, grains, wine, etc.
Suddenly Kelry's eyes light up with wine, just like...
And since this happens to be quite large, the rats can live there quite royally for at least a few months. That is, if you don't do anything.
Right.
So my first thought is here to the dwarf, man.
Now, what do you do first?
Can I jump in here, guys?
I'll run in first and go for the wine.
Wait,
but the door's locked, by the
way. I just recalled.
That's new.
I just recalled. Let us... You would... Yeah. Basically... Okay, guys, open up your character sheets, and then I would like you all to at least... Actually, no, not yet.
Okay.
I'm like, all right, then. I'm like good thinking job. Ahead at this point, but it will happen soon. So, let's just, who's doing what?
Left back and look back the door, man.
Right, that's pretty much it. I've got my thief's tools, which include a trusty lockpick. So what I'm going to try and do is lockpick that door, D-Man, because of course we've got no key. So, I mean, we don't want to break down this door, you know. There's a door, we just want to open it.
Well, I can burn it down if you want.
You'd probably burn down the whole place and all. You'd burn down everything in there.
You can't be trusted with your fire breath.
I vote we do.
What? You are.
Remember
using
what happened to your village.
Okay. Sad times, man.
Arogino the arsonist.
Shut up, man. Stupid
okay,
boss.
So then I want you to open up your character sheet.
Yep, so
and then you will need to do
dex roll.
There's a
it should
thing
be a dexterity check.
Mm-hmm. Is there not?
And if I recall, is there a spot where it says thieves' tools?
Yep.
You can use the thieves' tools in order to aid you, so there is that.
Mm-hmm.
This is so hard, man.
So I think you just
click the thieves' tools in there.
I think you click on the thieves' tools. Try that.
So right, what I do is I get the lockpick out, stick it in a hole, give it a bit of a wiggle, and I've got a roll of 27.
Damn!
Like that is a nat 20, boys. First roll of the game.
That's how you
damn, start. Damn, son.
That's how we start around here.
Good
holy
job,
crit!
Kelry doesn't fuck about.
Wait till wasted it there.
Wait till you later. RNG god will bite you in the ass.
Yeah. Holy shit. Just
D-Man wasn't expecting it to work.
No, I was not. But you just plain unlock it. Absolutely nothing else happens, and you all just. What, do you all just walk in now?
Well, I imagine I unlock it, open the door. What do we see inside? Like, how big is this larder? Because
why?
Can we see passes?
So, have we never been in this room before?
I've not been
there. No, that's why it's black in that.
I use my fire breath to lighten up the room. How about that?
Stop with your fire, Churi.
Bro.
That's the only building I know.
There's
a
wooden ceiling above. We do not want this building catching on fire.
Okay.
So, what else
now then.
It's too dark.
So can I walk into this room then? Because I'd be at the front.
Oh yeah, you could all just walk right in now. Like, thanks to the doors being open, you could all just, like. Oh, jeez.
Get back.
You just like all walk into about this area here.
Mm-hmm.
Where?
Well, how and far can we? I mean,
you could basically like here. I'll
move
the completely wrong thing.
Let me and Dwarf go first, man.
Yeah, I'll go first.
I'll join you, man.
Basically, everyone just move your pieces into the room at this point.
I don't know where how big the room is.
The room's blacked out, so
black.
We can't see it.
We need you to,
I'm in there, man.
Like, do a line of sight sort of thing.
Where is this? I think I need to move this.
Oh, someone! What?
Do I do that?
It's weird. It's still black, man.
Right, can you two stop doing a tango? Gary's at the door.
I don't. I am a noob at this. I will admit, full out, I am a noob at this.
Yep.
I'm in the room, man.
This is everyone's first time.
Let me see. How do I handle this then?
Oh, alright.
Get the guns.
Do I just knock this down or whatever? Like,
I think you might be able to do it. Like, cause you can click with lots of light.
On the stream. I'll not do that. I'll not.
Can you actually see everything yet, or?
No, it's still pitch black.
No, you can just like I put up, say, my character sheet. One of you could see what like is on my character sheet and all that. So I'm trying to like cut it down to the bits where I actually have to click and that.
Let me introduce my breath, man.
Second in throat.
Well, we can see these, like, two lines, so I imagine there's, like, a wall there or something. There's, like, little white lines.
I think it goes down in a bit to the right.
Oh, I mean,
Chewie, can you stop moving your stuff around, please?
Ooh, like, that's spooky, man. I saw
how
some rats,
do I move this? Oh, reveal areas. Thank you.
There we go.
I still see nothing, man.
Don't see
anything. It's still black.
Kelry and...
Wine! That's mine, man.
Running in. I'm
in.
Wait.
So we've all moved into...
Wine. So is this one partition?
So you can all see to about that area. You look around and... Does anyone does anyone want to give a quick perception check, perhaps?
That's go on, I'll do it. So
wait,
got it.
Wait. I'm screwing up a lot.
I can cool that.
I can do perception.
Oh, wait, here it is. This is where I need to start off. The heavy smell of giant rat shit hits your nostrils like hell. As the door swings open and you just you can hear the scamper of feet all over the place, and what
is it, quite dark?
They're about the size of golden retrievers or something like that. You can hear them all moving back and forth and stuff like that.
What's the size of the dwarf you told us, man?
Oh.
Is it really dark? Is that why we can't see? Or?
It was just because I did not do some things. But I
think...
So
it's well lit.
I think, maybe. I don't fully know at this moment. I'm still trying to work. I'm trying to.
It's okay, but
out, okay.
It's just if it's dark, I can actually see in the dark.
So. I can actually use my breath in the dark.
Look, I'm trying to work shit out. But anyways, you could hear them moving back and forth at the end of the room, and
I'll make a move.
Suddenly, what is this? You just hear them gnawing at crates, barrels, bags of food, etc.
Right.
Okay. So we're working off sound at the moment as opposed to seeing anything.
And between you and them, there's a huge set of basically crates and other stuff.
Mm-hmm. All right, okay, that's cool.
So...
Whoa! More items.
Wait,
no.
Chewie, stop moving around. Just stick in one position, okay, buddy?
Listen, man. I'm unpredictable.
And yet, you can tell that this was all just quickly moved by Ilaria in order to try and keep the rats from getting further out.
Filthy rats, man.
Mm-hmm. Now then, Would you... Now, does anyone want to... I don't know, look around or... try and move boxes? Something of the sort?
Well, I'm...
Yeah,
I like,
you're strong, lads. When you go lift some boxes.
Since there is wine in this larder, I'm just going to take my time.
Actually,
examine every bottle.
Just let me do the job, man.
Like I said, does anyone want to roll perception or something?
Rap, do you want to do the honors?
Sure. I'll look around.
Alright. I mean, you would...
I know, I'm getting it.
You would kind of know the place by now, so holy shit.
I don't know the place.
McGravy's been down here playing.
I'm still trying to look for the thing, man. I can't find it.
God fucking damn, man.
I think I find it, man.
It was almost a 20.
But yeah,
Did he die?
Oh shit.
You won't die from a 22.
Perception.
That's sad.
Perception overload.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to do it for Wizard of Edinburgh.
And then I want to right click that all.
So tell
and
us more
say...
graphic. What do your elfin eyes technically see?
Whoa! I see pink stuff, man.
Well.
Oh, now you see. What? Two X's?
I see some pink worms, man.
Yeah.
Just lines or X's?
One of them's a line and one's an X.
Yeah.
Which one's a line? Worms,
that's an X, that's a line.
This one here is a line. Okay, so I need to adjust that then. Thought that I had. There we go. Now I'm pretty sure that if I go to this and there, that should both be X's by now.
Yep.
Yeah.
And Grav, you. Mogravy, you notice that there are some holes over at these boxes at foot height.
Yeah, I want to look closer at this box.
Now, then you notice all of a sudden, where is this one? All of a sudden, boom, there are two rats coming through them, both.
Oh, hello.
So you're face to face with
I wasn't prepared for this, a
rattish Labrador.
They start charging out.
Golden rat retriever.
Now then, I want you all to do me a favor. First, click on your token. Then open up your character sheet and roll for initiative. As a matter of fact, I'm going to have to do so as well for these.
Wait, how do I open the token?
Right.
Oh,
click on initiative now.
Damn!
I don't know what to do, man.
14.
What am I supposed to do now?
Nah!
You got caught unawares by the rat.
What am I supposed to do, man?
Hello? What am I meant to do?
On your sheet, there's an initiative. Yeah. If you click on the letters, it's between armor class and speed. On your core.
Right.
Middle near the top, Chubbs.
I'm one of the 16, I guess.
Now then, I need to go to my area.
Mm-hmm.
I click this. I'm horrible.
And why is this not popping
up
yet?
Look at that.
So I'm guessing that's like deciding our turn order?
Yeah, this is turn order.
Then...
Wait, I clicked it, but I don't see mine.
What I need to do is where...
Just wait, it may be loading.
What is initiative again?
There we go, we've got turn order over there.
Cool.
Initiative is D20 plus...
Why have we only got four?
Yeah, Chubbs isn't there.
Yeah, I clicked on initiative, I heard a little...
Chubbs, you have to click your character.
Yeah, you have to click on your token before clicking initiative.
What's
a token?
Your character.
Your character on the
character you are.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Oh, hey. Bloody hell.
Oh, you've cheated. Cheat the system.
Change it to 6, you melon.
It didn't improve anything, though, because it's still, like...
Yeah.
I can actually switch that myself.
There you go.
Because Chewy should have been
above
me.
There we go, and then I need to... roll for initiative for these things, but I'm trying to figure out what the hell I need to roll for it. What
it's
is initiative based
it's
on
a
again?
D20 plus your dexterity bonus.
Okay, so did that roll?
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
Giant red.
Oh shit.
Whoa.
I didn't add that. I didn't click on any of the characters. Crap.
So,
but it would be an 18. Then I need to just like I don't know how I do this.
The same exponent. Do we just roll again?
I think I just need to add giant rat. That.
Then wait.
It is 18. Then I need to numerical descend.
An Asian rat.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. Now, what will really happen is, thanks to the player scoring first, then it is you who will go before Orianna. Now, I will remind you all this bit. Your speed, which is basically your movement, every 5 feet is one space. So you can move up to that amount of feet before making your attack.
Okay. Can we move? We can move past friendly characters, can't we? Because they don't take up like a 5 foot block.
You would have to be next to each other.
Yeah, but we can pass past each other.
Yes.
Yeah.
Close enough, I would think.
Because I'm going to assume that the dwarf and the lizard don't take up 10 feet between them.
No.
What are you trying to say here, mister?
I'm saying that you're not completely, like, morbidly obese.
Are you sure?
That might explain why you're only wearing a shirt.
Keep it that way. No, keep it that way.
Now then, Orianna.
Yes.
Make your move.
Alright then. My move. This is going to take a while. So...
Well, yeah, you've got to look at him.
It's 30, so we'll cover a wee bit.
Alright.
And then I get to use an action. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm going to then use can I then cast heroism on Aragenia?
You mad boy.
Casting which... heroism, I
yeah.
What is heroism?
Oh, breath.
It gives means that they're immune to being frightened and they gain temporary hit points equal to my spell casting ability modifier. For 1 minute.
They gain what?
Hit points equal to my spell casting ability modifier. But
so
it's more
that
so that he doesn't get afraid, because we know that his track record is that he's a bit of a coward, so you know.
We've got to make him brave here.
So you would be giving him temporary hit points.
Yeah, temporary hit points.
So yeah, sure. Yeah. Go right ahead.
Waiting for this roll.
Kablam. I don't think it's a roll, it's just like
right.
Oh, it costs just one action. So
he is willing. So
range is touch.
I don't need to
it's fine.
The duration is concentration up to 1 minute.
Yep, so as long as I'm like paying attention, I'm not interrupted.
He gains
now
you equal to your spell casting ability modifier.
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
By doing this, is this like your level 1 casting? Is your level 1 casting, or is it...
I've only got one level of casting, so he will gain one hit point, but it's more it's that he doesn't run away, because he's a coward.
I'm not there.
I've heard the stories, man.
Yeah.
But I go the dragon, man.
The dragonborn cometh, the dragonborn goeth.
Now, what is your spellcasting ability modifier, though?
That's a great
It's character. Because it's a level 1 spell.
Oh, it's a spell casting ability charisma, so I would guess it'd be my charisma bonus, which is a 3.
Your charisma bonus is 3?
That's correct.
I think it might be along the lines of... Okay, yeah, sure. So we'll say he gains 3 temporary hit points. Originia, would you please add that into your character sheet?
Okay. Under the cool bit on current hit, temporary.
There's a temporary hit
points. How many? Three?
You get three.
Three.
You did, man.
Nice. Cool. And then there's nothing else I can do because I have to concentrate on keeping Originia.
Give me cool.
For a full minute. So yeah, now it's the giant rats. It's like an entire slew of them, really. But
wait, is that both giant rats then at the same time, or
it means the entire group of them,
like little swarms, sort of thing.
Fair enough. Yeah.
They better not attack me, man.
So
Rick more gravity.
Yeah, the first one, as you're bending down, Grav, you see the rat come charging at you, and yet it just snaps at you. Now, since you're kind of looking down through this, you are slightly disadvantaged since it just appeared right there. Now, I'm trying to think here. Not the rat charge. I know, Goomba.
Not the rat charge.
But, let me see, where is this bit? Trying to think on how you avoid attacks? Like, I know there's something...
I don't think you can, I think it's just...
No, there is a way, like, I think it's dexterity.
Yeah, you roll dexterity for dodge, don't you?
I think, I need to double check on that, though. Fighting. Control F. Avoid. Let's try avoid. No attack. Okay, where is this one? Disengage. Oh, reactions, probably.
That's legit.
No, that doesn't look right. Why? Roll for initiative. All this other stuff. Why the hell?
I think it is dexterity.
Yeah.
Alright.
So is
I can't
to make
figure
a
this out.
Save.
I cannot figure this out. Damn. If anyone has any clue,
I'm not
like
my fifth edition, so.
If you got like fifth SRD open, could you take a look?
What's that, sorry?
Fifth SRD. It's like one of those bits. Now let me see.
Fifth SRD. Do you want me to check the little like compendium thing?
If you could find it there, then yeah.
This is fair.
Like,
we need someone.
There you go.
Like,
combat dodge. Yeah. When you take dodge action, you focus entirely on avoiding all attacks, so you can only dodge, I'd imagine, like, as your turn.
Oh, so you need to, like,
no,
prepare
it can...
the dodge beforehand.
No, it can be during an attack.
Their attack. But you can only, like, say,
that,
dodge one character's
that
attack.
That says, the way that sounds is if it's been prepared.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Like, it's delaying your action until something happens to you, so then you dodge out of the way.
Guys, I think I found it. Fortitude. These saves measure your ability to stand up to physical punishment or attacks against your vitality and health. Apply your constitution modifier to your fortitude saving throws.
Alright.
So that's for physical punishment. Then there's also reflex, which saves your ability to dodge area attacks, and that's your dexterity.
I think reflex would be more appropriate.
Yeah.
I just couldn't see it on the sheet, so I don't really know what was going on.
Okay, so let me at least try and.
I'm sending it to you somewhere.
Okay, now let me
put it in the game chat. There you go.
Alright.
Okay. Thanks. I just need to pop that open, then this. I'm getting real bad lag here and there because of the way my internet is.
So, do I roll Constitution or Dexterity then?
Fortitude, the saves measure.
Just wait until I figured it.
Reflex.
I think you'd roll for a reflex there.
Apply your dexterity modifier to your reflex. And yet, I'm pretty sure that I need to attack? Is that the attack then? Ah, here it is.
Here we go.
Wow. It'll take the first one. Actually, yeah, pretty much, because, as I said, you're somewhat disadvantaged. And I need to try and remember.
Mm-hmm.
I need to at least try and roll something in order to figure out whether it hits or not. Oh god.
It's just your attack roll, isn't it?
You know what? I think this is actually. It's been about an hour, so I think this is a good point to take a break.
So D-Man can quickly have a look at it. So yeah, we'll take
I can look just about everywhere, man.
So yeah, we'll take a quick, like, should we say 2-minute break?
Yeah,
just
sure.
Quickly go grab a drink and that.
Tea break.
Yeah.